Well, here we are again with ClydeSight and another one of my insane videos about technology. And this one is very different because it is not about a tape recorder. It's about something totally unexpected. And if you like things that are unexpected, I suggest you visit Amazon.com or Barnes & Noble and get a copy of my wonderful new science fiction book, The Rusara Trilogy, Volume 1, Star Hopper. This is a thinking person's science fiction novel. It is completely unexpected. Not all alien encounters are abductions. In this story, Paul, an Earthman, is visited by aliens, the Rusara, who come from the other side of the Milky Way galaxy to help him in response to a dream. How they picked up his dream and how he interacts with them is what the story is all about. It's all about relationships. And Paul, after being invited to visit the home planet of Warren, learns what it is like to live among alien beings. But it's not all fun and games. There's an enemy species named the Scaridan who capture Paul and hold him prisoner. Paul has to use all his wits and cleverness to beat the Scaridan at their own game, escape, and bring the Rusaran crew and the Starhopper to the home planet of Warren, where Paul discovers a world unlike anything he has ever known before. If you like this type of approach, please visit Amazon.com or Barnes & Noble and pick up a copy of the Rusara Trilogy, Volume 1, Starhopper. And it's available in Kindle format as well as Barnes & Noble Nook. You can also get it for the Sony Reader through Smashwords.com. Now let's get back to our unexpected find, the Kirby Sentria vacuum cleaning system.
Oh boy!
We're looking at the motor housing for the Sentria system, and it is an all-metal construction, heavy-duty aluminum. And I'm going to switch the light off so you can see how reflective. You see how the reflection changes on it? So we'll keep the lights down because this is so shiny and reflective. We're going to look at the motor unit first, and then we're going to look at the accessories and other parts of the system. So if this does not look like a vacuum cleaner to you, that's because it's not fully constructed yet. Under the hood, we see the motor and the impeller. It is made of a heavy-duty metal, and it provides both suction and, through this part of the shaft, drive to the rotary head and other parts of the system when it is configured, because there are several configurations you can have for it. The machine also has, on the cover here, three LED lights that provide plenty of illumination. And if we look further from the front, we can also see that there are wheels here. These are the front wheels for driving the system. And all of this mechanism is for clipping the different parts on and off the system. It's basically a convertible type of vacuum system. So it's a little bit more complicated to use than an all-in-one, but it gives it a lot more flexibility. Now let's take a look at the side of the unit. On this side, we can see the wheels. Now, these are the idler wheels, but these are the drive wheels, and I'll talk more about that in a second. This is a great feature on this machine. We also have our level adjustment for the carpet depth or bare floors, and there are two ways of adjusting it. One is to use this lever here, and that lowers it. And then this lever here raises it, trying to keep it from rolling off the table. So these are both activated by your feet, and it's very convenient to use. We also have a vent here. Now if we look on the back, we're going to see some very interesting secrets of the Kirby system. This is obviously going to be for the handle. Here is your power switch on and off. But here is one of the things about this Kirby machine that absolutely sold me on it. it has a drive system. Now, when you push this side, it says N on it. That disengages the drive system, so the machine can just easily roll around. If you push it on the other side, which says D, it engages the drive system. And it makes it harder to move by hand, but when it's powered, it moves almost by itself. You only need the slightest pressure to move this around on the floor. This gives you a tremendous advantage when you're carpeting rugs using the beater wand, because the friction of the beater wand against the carpet makes it very hard to move any vacuum cleaner. This drive system takes over for you, and it does the work. Now, as some of you may know, I had a heart attack in May. I needed a system that would not strain me, and this came to my rescue. Now, let's take a look at the other side. As we can see here, again, we see the wheels, but we also see the power cable, which is permanently affixed to the machine, and a bizarre-looking cup. This is not actually a suction cup. This is the blower for the bag, and the bag will attach here. And there is also a built-in, down here, a built-in safety switch. So if you don't have the bag attached, you're not going to turn the machine on. It's just not going to run. Looking at the underside, we can see that the system is very nicely sealed. Here's the drive system. You can see some of the gear. There's a little bump here for the gears that are inside that work the drive system. And it's all closed up so that it's not going to pull a lot of dirt into it. Now, let's take a look at how we can put in some of the attachments that we need. For carpet cleaning, the first thing we're going to need is the beater brush attachment. This is the power wand for the machine. This does all the cleaning on your carpet because it has a rotating brush. As you can see, here is the brush. And underneath this plate here, which is removable, you'll see the flat belt that drives the system. Now that belt comes up through this hole here, and there's a special mechanism that holds the belt in position for when you insert it in the machine, so you cannot screw up putting the head on the machine and not getting the belt to work. It's pretty much foolproof. You can get this apart if you get something jammed in it. I have had some experience doing that with a few cat toys, and the machine didn't destroy the cat toys, it just simply stalled and allowed me to know that there was a problem, and I just simply turned it upside down and pulled the toy out. When you buy the machine, you're going to get complete training from the salesperson on how to use the machine. I'm just going to show you very quickly what to do. If the machine is in the lowest position, you need to raise it up using the lever that I showed you on the side here. You lift the top, you take your head, and it hooks into, as you see this bar here, the head is going to hook into the bar. You hook it into the bar, swing it up, close the latch, and then you have to get the belt engaged. You open this lever, you simply turn it, and the belt is now engaged and the system is ready to work. Now, one of the safety features on this machine is that when this head is off, there's a safety interlock that I showed you, which is right here, which will not allow the machine to run. When this head is on, it activates the safety lock and allows power to go to the machine as long as the bag is in here. So it's a two-way safety system. You have to have some kind of head on the machine, and you have to have a bag on the machine. You just simply close it down, and then we're ready for the next part, which is simply to install the bag for here and the handle for here. You will get a large handle with the machine. You also get a portable handle, which I'll discuss in a minute. But this is the large handle, and it is so large that obviously it's not going to show up in the camera view. But the handle simply slips in here. You push it down, and it locks in. There is a switch here that has three positions, and it helps lock the handle in. If it's in the middle position, the handle can be swung back and down, and it will naturally swing back up by itself. You see, it's hard to tell, but I'm just using my thumb to move that. If you put it into the lock position, the handle will not move. And if you put it into the other lock position, it only goes down part way. So you have a lot of flexibility in the system. Now the handle, of course, has to be on first so that you can get the bag in. This is the bag. Now, the way the bag works is this part of the bag engages this part of the mechanism and it locks in. And the bag has notches on it that work with the safety switch that's built into the side of the machine. So all you do is you put the bag in and then you turn it, and it's very difficult, and now it's locked. Now you simply take the other end of the bag and hook it up into the wand. Now obviously the camera has not shown you absolutely everything, so I'll pan it up so you can see. You see the thing is really too big for the table, but it gives you the idea of how it works. And now the system is ready to run. At this point I could turn it on and it would attack the camera. So I'm not going to do that. Now I'm going to show you some other features. Remember, if you buy one of these machines, your salesperson will take you through everything. Their presentation is very, very thorough. And when you buy the machine, you get a DVD, and you get an instruction manual, and you get an accessories manual so that you can work with the complete system. You may not want to use this machine entirely for carpet cleaning. There are many other things you need to clean, and this machine is going to help you clean them. For that, you're going to need your outboard system, what I call the outboard system, which is, of course, a hose. And this hose lets you use vacuum cleaner attachments for cleaning drapes and sofas and chairs and all sorts of things. So I'm going to show you how that works now. To disengage the head, you simply lift the top, and first you disengage the belt, open up the system here, turn it counterclockwise until the arrows line up here. Now release this catch and the whole thing comes out. One end of this hose, which is very, very flexible and is almost crush-proof, is specially made to fit on the head. Now one of the tricks about it is it has this arm here. That's your safety catch. So you cannot run the machine without the hose or, of course, the power head on. So to put the hose on, you simply hook it into the mechanism just like you did the other one, the power head, and then turn this lever and close down the top, and you're ready to go. And this is the other end of the wand. There are a number of attachments that fit here. I'm not going to go through all the attachments because there are tons of them, but almost any cleaning need you have is covered by the attachments that come with this unit. And the attachments and this hose come in their own caddy, which you can carry around or you can mount on a wall. Now, don't forget that when you hook this up, you have to have the bag attached. Now, I'm going to show you how this can be used as a handheld. The system also comes with this handle, and that handle slips right into the back, like this. You push it down, and you now have a handle to carry the machine. So you can lift it up and carry it around with you. But don't forget, you still have to have the bag. Don't ever forget that bag. Well, you don't have to worry, it won't run without it. But this makes it convenient for kind of carrying it around if you're going on stairs and things. And the bag will flip around and plug into the back of the handle here, so it doesn't have to be way up and down the way it was with the large handle. If you just got this with the machine, the power head and the wand and the attachments and the handle, that would be pretty complete. But that's not the end of the story. There's still more. The Kirby system is more than just a vacuum, it's also a blower. And for that, you can take your hose here and plug it into where the bag would normally go. All you do is put it on the machine and then twist it on. And now this hose will act as a blower. But remember how there's a safety catch here? Plus, you don't want this motor spinning around without some kind of protection. Well, Kirby thought of an answer for that. In the attachment caddy, you will get this very bizarre looking device. This is your intake for when you're using it as a blower. You simply hook it on, push it up, and lock it down. And now you have a complete blower system. And this is so powerful that this can be used to blow leaves. I don't want to take it outside and do that. I don't want to ruin it. I like it so much the way it is. But you could actually do that. Now that's kind of useful and helpful, but why would you need to blow anything with a vacuum cleaner? I'm going to show you. This machine can also shampoo. It can shampoo rugs, it can shampoo drapes, it can shampoo furniture. And for drapes and furniture and things that are up off the floor, unless you're planning to lift this thing up and try to make it work, which you cannot do, they came up with a solution, which is this sort of gun. I mean, it looks like a spray gun for spray painting. And it comes with a special head, which you just simply put on the end. It's a diffuser head, and it has a trigger. The other end of it simply plugs into the hose, and now you have a spray shampooer. You fill this bottle with water and the special shampoo they give you, turn on the machine, aim it at your sofa, and off you go. What it puts out is not a liquid, it's a foam. So it foams your furniture and your drapes clean. This is amazing that they would package this in with the machine. And it's not over yet. Depending on your salesperson and the specials or whatever special sales they have at the time are, you may also get, and you can also purchase separately, this very bizarre looking device. This device is intended for shampooing your carpet. And it does a great job. Now what you do, it works very much like the power head. It has a rotating brush, soft bristle brush here, you can see the belt here, and this is going to scrub the soap solution into the carpet, and then it's also going to pull the whole thing up. So what you have to do is simply attach it to the front of the machine. And it works very much like the power head that we used. And now we just simply engage the belt by turning the disc, and we're almost ready to go. But how does this thing actually get any soap suds into the carpet and suck them up? It's very easy. You get a tank, and you fill this tank with water up to a certain level, and you put in a cap full of solution, and the cap is marked so that you can fill it up properly, and you pour it into the tank, screw it down, maybe give it a little shake, and then this end, which has a filter, and it has the notches again for the safety interlock, goes where the bag would go. So now this is mounted on the machine. The final part is this amazing hose. The red end goes into the tank, and the tank is marked with a red collar, so you can't mess that up. And the other end snaps down like that. So now we're all ready to do some shampooing. And of course you can close down the top so that you can see. The way it works is amazing. As the machine runs, it blows air through here into the tank, creating a foam. The foam comes out through the hose, goes down through the hole in the bottom here, and puts the foam onto the carpet. So you push the machine forward, and then as you pull it back, the brushes work the foam into the carpet. You wait a little bit, and the manual will tell you how long to wait. Usually it's about 5-10 minutes. And then you turn this dial here to shut off the foaming function, and the brushes are still running and it's still vacuuming. Now when you go over what was foam, the foam will have disappeared by now. What happens is the brush pulls up the foam, and the machine, instead of putting it in here, which is where you would expect it to go, it blows it into this tray. So this tray winds up collecting all the water or foam and dirt from the carpet. This comes off, and you pour it out, and it's all cleaned. So there you have it, a brief exploration of the Kirby Sentria vacuum cleaning system. Now you may be wondering, why didn't I show you this machine actually working, and why didn't I turn it on? Well, it's a very, very loud machine, and I don't want to harm the microphones on my camera with the noise. So there are plenty of videos on YouTube that show you these machines in action and how they work. I wanted to show you how easy it is to change things around on the machine for the different configurations. One thing that I really love about the machine is its wonderful retro look. When the power head is on the machine, to me, it looks like an old 1930s airplane. It's just really, really attractive looking. It is a bit heavy. It's about 25 pounds. And I've been enjoying this machine very much, and it has obviously been cleaning my carpets very well. I would not make a video about this machine and tell you about it if I didn't think it was a good product. Thank you for watching the video on the Kirby Sentria vacuum cleaning system. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you like things that are unexpected and different, don't forget to visit Amazon.com or Barnes & Noble's and pick up a copy of the Rosara Trilogy Volume 1 Starhopper. It's only $9.95, and it'll run on your Kindle or your Nook. And if you want, you can even get it for the Sony Reader. All you have to do is go to Smashwords.com. Links are located in the video description of this video on YouTube. Until next time, when we'll probably look at a tape recorder again, this is ClydeSight saying bye-bye.